Today is the second chapter of Blood Bank. We are going to skip one chapter. We're going to go directly to human anti-human globulin test, direct and indirect anti-human globulin test. As you may or may not know, if we have red blood cells in a saline solution, in normal saline solution, the red blood cell will have a net negative charge, This in a saline solution. So the smallest distance between two red blood cells would be about 25 nanometer. So these how RBCs look in a saline solution. No, why they have this? They are not touching. They could not be touching because the repulsion of the negative charge. The repulsion of the negative charge make a distance between the two cells. It's called 25 nanometers. The repulsion of the two negative charges is called zeta potential. The zeta potentials make the negative make the distance between the two RBCs, any two RBCs, about 25 nanometers. Now, to lower the zeta potential means to lower the number of negative charge on red blood cells, mean we lower the distance. We lower the distance of between two red blood cells. The reason I'm saying that, because you know, as we all learned, in the ABO group, the antibody are IgM. In the rhesus group or H group, the antibody are IgG. IgM, the distance between about 35 nanometer. Benamel, IgG spans less than 25 nanometer. So this is very important. If we have red blood cells here, and I know the distance is 25 nanometer, if we have IgM, the IgM can agglutinate RBC because the spans of the two arms is bigger, can reach from here to here. Bainama, if we have IgG and you have reagent here, only the minimum distance is 25 nanometer, and if we put IgG, this arm will attach to this antigen, but this arm cannot attach to this antigen because it's less than 25 nanometers. So if we have antigens with IgG attached, these cells are called, as you very well know, sensitized cell. These cells that have IgM will agglutinate. And we can see it. Agglutinin, we can see it. But these, if we have the reaction antigen antibody, we will have sensitized cells and it looks negative to us, like we talked about it last time. Now, and this is a big problem in blood banking, because we have to know whether there is really antigen. There is really antigen here, and these cells are sensitized. Now, the way they worked out, they tried early on to lower the zeta potential, One way we can agglutinate antigen with IgG is to lower the zeta potential. You mean to lower the distance between two RBC to less than 25 nanometer, so that two arms of the IgG can bind two or more cells. How they do it? First, they did it using proteolytic enzyme, like trypsin. Trypsin, as it's in your manual, will cut the sialic acid, which is it's a glycoprotein, which is negatively charged, the lower the potential. They did it by adding albumin. Albumin will cover, they think, the negatively charged RBC, lowering the potential, or by using polycation reagent, polycation, you know, a compound with a lot of positive charge, to also cover the negative charge, neutralizing charge on RBCs, and lower the system potential, or using low ionic strength solution, the same thing, low ionic solution, the same thing, all these. In order to use this or this or this or this, in order for us to lower the number of negatively charged on the RBCs, lowering the distance between the RBC to less, between these two RBCs to less than 25 nanometer, and thus this sensitizer can agglutinate. So the IgG can reach from one arm on one RBC and another arm on the other RBC. Now, as you may well know, and I told you last week, a nice guy, his name is Coombs, came up with a brilliant idea. He said, why don't I raise antibody against IgG? He said, can a bridge between the distance between two IgG and thus agglutinate those cells. So what he did, he came up with anti-human globulins, like anti-antibody. If a cell is sensitized antigen antibody, but not agglutinated, this guy came up with anti-human globulin that can bridge, that bind with this and this and this and this, and thus agglutinate. So, to know whether the cells is sensitized, we add anti-human globulin. If we get a positive reaction, agglutination, mean the cells is already sensitized. If we don't have agglutination or negative reaction, the cells mean not sensitized. Now, we have two types of anti-human globulin or Coombs test. Direct anti-human globulin test or direct Coombs, and indirect anti-human globulin or indirect Coombs. Let's start with direct. Direct anti-human globulin test. This one again, direct Coombs test. This test is used to detect sensitized cells in vivo. It means if the cells have been sensitized in vivo. Vivo means inside the human body. So if we have a cells that has a red blood cell that have antibodies attached to it, like it was sensitized inside the body. Now, if we know whether it's sensitized or not inside. Okay, in what cases where we see this phenomenon? Well, first, in hemolytic disease of a newborn. Hemolytic disease of newborn, where the mother is D negative and the baby is D positive. We see it sometimes in cases where autoimmune disease. Somehow your immune system, you know, made the antibody against one of your RBC antigen. We see it third in drug induced hemolytic anemia, where you are most, you know, I will give you an example of a drug that could induce hemolytic anemia is penicillin. Penicillin sometimes in higher dose could induce antibody against the insulin, against the penicillin. But penicillin here, in this case, bind to red blood cells, penicillin. And when the antibody against, not against the antigen of the RBC, because against the penicillin is already bound to RBC, and this is where the hemolysis can take place. And the other case is transfusion reaction. Number four, transfusion reaction. Transfusion reaction, you are A negative, and we gave you, for example, A positive. You don't have a D, we gave you a B. You're gonna induce anti-D. The anti-D is gonna bind in vivo inside the body to your RBC. So, and it will induce hemolytic anemia. These three cases where the antibody suspected to be attached to the antigen on the RBC in vivo. So the RBC is already sensitized. All we have to do is take the RBCs and add anti-human globulin. If it's positive, mean the RBC has already sensitized in vivo, and if it's negative, mean there is no sensitization. There is no sensitization. For some reason, hemolysis is not because antigen antibody. So this is the idea. All is this direct is you take the cells, you don't add anything, you wash the cells, you don't add anything, you add anti-human globulin to the cells. If it's a positive, means somehow the cells are sensitized in the in vivo. Now, mother, this is the most common. Mother is D negative and the baby is D positive. I'm sure Dr. Raed will explain it to you. I don't have time for you to explain how, but this is the theory part. Now, what can we do right now? What can we do right now is the experiment for direct antiglobulin test.
knafot. We have a patient, we suspect this patient is having an in vivo sensitization. Now, the patient has an in vivo sensitization, his RBC will look be looking like this. Antigen, 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 antigen. Antibody. These are sensitized cells. If it's positive, if it's negative, the RBC will look like this. No, this negative, this no antigen attached or no sensitization. What are we gonna do? Enough of patient, wash the cells, two tubes, patient, one for example, control, one, two tubes. Add two drops of anti-human globulin and two drops of anti-human globulin. Hey, our shit. Second, we're gonna add to each tube two drops of patient washed cells 2 to 5%. Oh, I made a mistake here. Pay attention to the mistake. This is control here. Two drops of what? Of albumin. 20%. Because it's a control. One, two drop of anti-human globulin. Here, the patient cells, and here's the patient cells. Remember, the control has always, should always be positive. Alpha should always be negative. Should always be negative. So the reason we use control, we only have one patient. If it's a positive, we don't need it to be for spontaneous agglutination, as I said. That's why we use control. So if it's by itself a positive, there is a possibility could be spontaneous agglutination, not because antigen antibody. That's why we use control. Now, we spin dislodge and look for agglutination. This must be negative, no control. If it's positive, we cannot do interpretation. There must be some sort of patient spontaneously agglutinate. For patient, if it's a positive, this mean, why is it positive? It means here, the patient's cells already looked like this. When we added anti-human globulin, this is what happened. And these anti-human globulin attached and bridged these things and agglutinated. So that's positive. That's that patient mean is sensitized in vivo. Sensitized to where? In vivo. Could be for this reason. This reason or that reason. Could be, depends, autoimmune disease, direct inherited, so whatever they suspect. If it is negative, it was what? Negative, you know, no agglutination. Know what? Agglutination. In this case, we don't wanna declare directly negative. we have to incubate the cells at room temperature for 5 minutes. If it's negative, and spin after that, if it stays negative, mean it's negative. If it's positive, mean it is a positive. Always, when we get a negative for anti-human globulin cells, we have to use what? Check cells, a sensitized cells, and to make sure that the anti-human globulin we are using is working. Is working. Now, we are gonna go directly to the test.